Jamie, very much like the name of your 2009 short film, it's nice to meet you.
I love that. Yeah, nice to meet you.
From Hollywood all the way to Hollywood, you are starring with Wonder Woman herself. Can you tell me, did she give you any fight scene tips, seeing as that she is Wonder Woman?
You're just trying to sort of, you know, follow her lead. You know, she's so comfortable in this world, whereas I'm probably not so much because I've done a ton of fighting stuff and enough action stuff in like war dramas and stuff that I've done, but not at this scale, this level. And watching her just be, it's such a part of her like DNA and her sort of acting DNA and her career DNA that it's just kind of inspiring to be around it and watch her do it with such ease. Look, I like to think that I could sell myself to be believed.
Parker was fantastic. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool, thanks. Yeah, I enjoyed all that side of it, yeah, but she's definitely a total pro.
As long as there was any Anchorman rules of, like, no touching of the hair and face, I assume that's the main...
What a movie.
So your pal, Niall Horan, recently gave you a little bit of a shout-out saying, you're the most handsome man in the world, so I figured we might want to give him some love back, okay? So if we were to cast Niall in a film like Heart of Stone, what kind of role could we give Niall Horan in a film like this?
He's some little creepy, stalker type person, maybe. You know, that's what I think would suit Niall, you know.
See, I can tell you he's a real friend because not many can get away with that.
No. I'm so proud of him. Jesus, he's just got just number one album there, like in many different countries in the world. So I'm very proud of wee Niall at the moment. And he was totally wrong what he said about me. He's just where he's got that from.
Oh, well, look, there is a particular scene in Half Stone where you're donning a suave suit. And don't worry, I'm not going to ask that James Bond question, but I give you a choice. If you could play either James Bond or make the sequel to my favorite movie, Barb and Star Go to Vista Del Mar, which would you choose?
I don't think I'm being asked to do either. I'm constantly on the Kristen and Annie to do another Barb and Star because there's so many different places you can take that. I feel we were really screwed with timing of that and COVID and when that came out because there's people like yourself, if you find that movie, you love that movie.
Oh, yeah.
And it definitely has a very strong fan base that I'm very aware of, but maybe there wasn't enough to do another. But I'm going to keep banging that drum and seeing if we can do it. I think that call seemingly will come before the other call, which isn't going to come.
We need to hear Edgar singing again, man. The son
That's
of Jim.
The thing, yeah, I'm going to say that. I'd love to sing more with Edgar, yeah.
For sure. So in the film, the heart itself is a really powerful object that helps predict the future. Jamie Dornan could use that in his real life to predict something in the future, what would you get it to predict? And don't say golf, okay? Golf scores, because I know you love your golf.
Literally going straight to golf.
You can say golf. It's okay.
Oh, you know, I know. I wouldn't like some back to the future, like the way of winning sports bets. I don't want to do that. If you could predict some way to actually legitimately help the world and predict how it is that we can actually bring peace to the world and stop people starving to death when everyone else is making lots of money, that would be a pretty, pretty great way of using it.
Amazing. And look, Netflix has a huge event right now. I mean, Brazil, you were there. I was wondering, are there any other Netflix kind of series or films that you absolutely can't wait to see or you've already watched recently that you absolutely love?
Yeah, I'd love to see more Red Notice when there's a lot of talk about, you know, a couple of sequels for that. I really find that entertaining. So obviously supporting Gal with that. My elder two kids love Wednesday, so I've watched a lot of Wednesday with them.
That makes sense.
They are obsessed with Jenna Ortega, and I don't even know if she is here in Brazil. I wouldn't tell them if she was because they'd put too much pressure on me to like get a photograph of her, and I didn't want to be the sort of creepy older guy saying, "Hey, this is for my kids. Come and take a picture." So I didn't see Jenna Ortega. I don't know her, but my kids are obsessed with her, and I think, you know, she's amazing. Yeah, probably Wednesday, just for my own kids' sake. They'd be so excited about that.
Yeah, well, you know, Wednesday season two is coming, of course. And speaking of your kids, hey, happy Father's Day, man! Because I'm a dad
as well.
You. This is Father's Day to both of us.
Happy Father's Day to you. There we go. Yeah.
Thanks, man. Yeah. There's incredible film locations in the film. Hearthstone's got amazing set pieces. Which place did you love filming in the most? Which country?
Like, it was easy when we were in London. We did the most of it in London. But I loved the first week we were in the Dolomites up in the Italian mountains on the border of Austria. The food was amazing up there. It was kind of like torture because you sign a contract saying you will not participate in any like dangerous sports. So all the crew are going like skiing during the day. We're doing night shoots and I love skiing and I wasn't able to do that. It was frustrating. But we finished up in Lisbon and it was summer in Lisbon and I spent a lot of time in Lisbon. We actually have a place out there and I love it out there. So and my family came out with me for that and we stayed a couple of weeks after and had a holiday and stuff. So I'm going to say Lisbon. Yeah.
Thanks so much. Have a lovely day and I'll speak to you soon, Jamie.